I am Commissioner Urban Land Transport in Karnataka. So I think Karnataka is one of the states which has set up this Directorate of Urban Land Transport. So we do carry out a lot of mobility studies for various cities across Karnataka, and also preparation of parking policy and many other urban transport initiatives. And so far as the parking policy is concerned, we have made a parking policy for Bangalore. And for the last 1 year, we've been trying to get some consensus on that. The parking policy was initially prepared by a consultant for us, and then we had put it on our website, and we also used some internet communities which are in Bangalore to elicit public opinion on that. And then finally, on the basis of the comments, etc., we formulated a policy. And now the policy has got in principle approval of the urban local body. Now we hope to take it forward and then implement the components of the parking policy.
What are the major provisions of the components?
Basically we are saying parking cannot be free. As of now in Bangalore, parking is free. So the parking policy, the core element is that parking has to be priced, and the pricing is to be differential. So it should depend on whether it is a short term or a longer term parking, whether it's on street parking or off street parking. In case it's an on street parking, it should be costlier than the off street parking. Because we have done some studies on multi-level car parks and in Bangalore, and we have found they are virtually empty on weekdays because on-street parking is free. So that is one aspect. The second aspect is to provide parking for cycles in all the parking lots, etc. And then using technology in parking, like parking meters and things like that. And finally, to look at the parking standards themselves and to try and introduce over a period of time maximum parking standards rather than minimum parking norms, which are the standard as of now, because there has to be a cap to parking. So we are looking at parking as a transport demand management measure. So that is the idea. So unlimited parking supply is not the objective of the parking policy. The objective of the parking policy is to restrict parking supply, leverage parking supply so as to negatively influence the growth of personal vehicles.
Thank you. Could you also talk a little about the neighborhood level planning exercises that
you recently started? We have been very actively promoting non-motorist transport, and we are working with the local urban body, that is the BBMP, and we have got NMT plans prepared for various neighborhoods. Recently we started one project in Malleshwaram. This is with we entered into MOU with a local community organization called Jaga, which works with the neighborhoods and which has been actually working in documenting the historical and cultural legacy of a neighborhood. So because in the neighborhood the footpaths are not just a means to access a, let's say, transit center. They're also means to access many places of interest. Could be a temple, or could be a yoga class, or could be whatever. So we have now we entered a MOU with this organization, and we have started this. We had this kickoff meeting on 1st of December, where we intend to work with the community. Our resident volunteers and transport planners will go from house to house and elicit opinion of people on what kind of neighborhood they want, what kind of cycling and pedestrian infrastructure facilities they would like to have, and what are the other issues that they find in the issues of concern they find in their neighborhood. So we hope to prepare get a plan evolved on the basis of the feedback from the local community. So first kickoff meeting we had, and the other the later on at every repeated intervals we do intend to have some workshops with the community, and finally we want a plan which is prepared by the community itself, and these details are there on www.yourmap.in. This is the Malleshwaram accessibility project. So we also have a Facebook page on that. So we're trying to use the ICT tools also, apart from actually contacting and talking to people, and preparing something which they own.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.